teams have gone through the formalities, and time to welcome Tommy Mooney this afternoon. the closest of shots. Towards the penalty area, Hughes turns it on, Sierra rises to head it away. It's on the left-hand side, his cross takes a flexion off Andrews, and Sierra at the near post has to head it behind for the first corner of the afternoon. 3 minutes played, 0-0.
Yeah, they certainly want to get the ball into wide areas and put crosses into the box.
Now Sierra.
A little bit more tempo, isn't there, in the team when Sierra Alta has the ball in the middle of the pitch there. He's trying to do things quickly as opposed to slow and sideways and backwards that we've seen so many times here at Vicarage Road this season. There's an intention to play the ball forward. If it's not on, then keep it and go sideways.
Sierra Alta again, inside the centre circle, almost on the centre spot. Infield for Sierra Alta and Porteous again. Sierra Alta. Andrews hugging the right hand. Andrews and Porteous again under pressure from Reese, but feeds Sierra Alta.
Very old.
But looks for Dennis. It's headed back into the Watford half. Sierra Alta heads it. Exchanges passes, and now Sierra Alta.
Changes of play.
Sierra Alta has to be quick to get there ahead of Emil Reese. Out to Porteous. And here's Sierra Alta again on the edge of his own box. Preston to clear. But Sierra Alta will win it back. It's a good spell for Watford. Yep, nutmeg from Sierra Alta. Fair to say he was nowhere near there. Sierra Alta has to lean in and prevent a little ball from Reese reaching Osmajic, but then can't keep the ball in. And Preston will have a second corner.
Had a little bit more time than he thought there.
We've had a situation where like three teams almost get 100 points and someone misses out on automatic promotion.
Well, with that look.
We're back underway. Alan McCann waiting to come back on. So Preston defending with 10 at the moment. Here's Porteous, 15 yards into
time. It was Dennis that his first touch just let him down.
But that type of ball, we've seen it a couple of times from Preston now. It's the longer ball with plenty of height on it.
These centre backs, there's not a lot of pace there. But when the ball's up in the air, they're all going to fight for it. And like you say, this wind today, it is swirling around the stadium. Makes it all the more difficult to pick up the flight of the ball.
There's Francisco Sierra Alta curling it forward. Dennis will get there and lays it off. Oh, heads it away. Brady heads it back towards the edge of the Watford penalty area. Sierra Alta heads it away. Preston will have a throw. Bio's just come over to mention something to Tom Cleverley. Porteous works an infield for Sierra Alta. He was under pressure from Reese, but drives it in low. Sierra Alta is there to clear for the Hornets. Into the Preston half. Tom Cleverley down, but
he obviously knew he was in an offside position with no concern.
Watford nil, Preston North End nil on Hive Live. They played nearly 26 and a half minutes. Turn it back to Woodman. Goes up to the halfway line. It's too high for Reese. Sierra Alta stoops forward and heads it away. Headed infield by Hughes. Sierra Alta heads it away.
A bit dry because they're getting caught with the ball under their feet. It's like it's not Taylor stand. And then
it into the penalty area. More distance on that one. Sierra Alta heads it away. Bio will the referee about.
I think his boots are bright green against the white line, but it looks like it was certainly the one.
Looks for Reese, who flicks it on, but Sierra Alta's there, takes it on his chest and then volleys it up in the air. Bit of an up and under. Lee Hutzfink, we're back underway. Here's Sierra Alta. Puts his foot on it.
Foot.
Brady swings the ball into the penalty area. Sierra Alta heads it away. Now Sierra Alta, edge of the centre circle. 5 minutes of the first period. Sierra Alta exchanges passes with Kayembe, and then Bio is there as well, but it's an outstretched leg of Cunningham that diverted it away. Watford have it again with Kayembe. Turns it back to Sierra Alta, who first time work it for Hutt, edge of the back towards Sierra Alta. His clearance at Cannon's high into the Vicarage Road end stand. Jack Watmore went closest early on with a header from a corner that went inches wide, and then Andrew Hughes perhaps should have scored for Preston right at on 45 minutes, but drilled his shot across the face of goal. And all handshake between the pair of them. And now we get back underway. Here's West. flicking it forward, looking for Osmaier, which played it the wrong side of the to Kayembe, has to get back into his own half and Sierauta. Nice little turn. And Sierauta. Andrews made a Cunningham chips it forward, one for Osmaier to chase, and that forces Sierauta to turn the ball behind.
End of his boot to it, almost bounced past him. I think it's just, it's not just Watford players, both players from both teams are just struggling to get the flight of the ball. Obviously with this
0-0, 6.5 minutes played of the second half. And Brady can intercept and he fires a long ball forward looking for Osmaier. Sierauta heads it away, but into touch for Preston. Find Sierauta. Into the feet of Kayembe. Look for Andrews. Poked away from him by Hughes. Sierauta chests the ball out to the right hand side. Stories there ahead of Dennis. Rhys looking to go on the outside of Sierauta, who holds him off. Good back.
He wants to hit that diagonal, doesn't he, Hoot? Just with a plenty of pace on it.
Batman has to move 45 yard effort at Hull to win the game. It's a more of a chipped effort, that one. That was just driven. Kayembe can't work the ball out to the right hand side. It spins back to Sierauta and Hoot back towards the halfway line by Hughes. Here's Sierauta. Towards a near post this time. Sierauta rises highest to head it away. Back to Brady. Sierauta closes him down, but he does get the cross away. And Watmore with a free header. Wide of the left, who nods it back for Hoot. Hull have extended their lead again at Cardiff to 2 goals. So Cardiff 1, Hull 3 now. Sierauta brings it forward. Shatford Tadred made a run, but didn't spot him. It's cut in half. Asprilla. Coins it. Porteous thought about making a run into the box, but it just worked sideways to Sierauta, back to Hoot once again. Shatford Tadred with the corner, towards the far post this time. Sierauta heads it down, but it bounces him.
It's comfortable in the end for him, isn't it?
It rolls the ball out to the Watmore, and Keane will encourage Rhys to run again on the left-hand side. Keeps the ball in, Sierauta pokes it away from him.
For Asprilla, isn't he, to try and get possession of the ball. See how frustrated he is.
Lobbed forward by Hughes. Sierauta volleys it into touch. Stoke 1, Preston 2. Stoke have a goal back.
Can read it.
Sierauta brings it forward for the Hornets. It's into the feet of Rybic. Shields it inside
between the posts. Try and get in that 6-yard box for another goal.
Sierauta gets a shove from Osmaier against Plymouth Argyle back in August. ...15 minutes to find a goal.
The team have offered any real quality in the final third.
Of course this as well, with the trips to Ipswich and Southampton to come. Porteous battling with Rhys. The ball falls for Sierauta and here's Delibashi. Rhys will get there ahead of Keane and make it back to Sierauta. The area, Delibashiru keeps it alive. Better that though from Watford there. More looks for Rajevic, but the ball was too far for Rajevic to control. It's an on. We're back underway. Watford clears over the halfway line. Sierauta heads it away. Porteous and Keane go to ground. Sierauta keeps his eye on the ball and finds. Here's Lewis back inside, goes for goal, cannons off McCann. That was all of 35 yards as well. Delibashiru again, his touch lets him down. Press to the halfway line, Sierauta retrieves it. Biddy is back on and he heads the ball away. Sierauta gets there, ahead of Keane, but Hook can't keep.
Obviously lost against Birmingham and today, unless they're drastically different at home.
Half, Porteous who plays Sierauta into a little bit of half. And that will cost them.
They're of the same opinion as us. This is a must-win game for Preston.
Well, they haven't won it.